As in all old medieval manors or castles, you don't quite know what to expect. When we first drove up, we thought, yep, this is another really old country manor. But as we got to really exploring the architecture, we saw the intricate details. And then when we went inside, we were astounded. All of the upholstery had been newly refurbished, the drapes. Our room was gorgeous. We went for tea. We met nice people. We saw beautiful woodwork and artifacts, artwork. And the lovely ladies here are celebrating their birthday on 9/10. A picture of Catherine Parr, who was unfortunately once married to Henry VIII. An antique wind bellow to fan the fire. He's so cute and photogenic. This was indeed our beautiful room at the Ston Easton. I also discovered something in the antique bureau, a secret drawer. You push back the felt and voila, a lady's makeup table, full of little bottles for perfume because they didn't bathe, and all kinds of little holding boxes for trinkets or whatever they needed it for. Obviously, I was very intrigued with this. Finding a parking space in Bath was not easy at all. Once we made it to the baths and the museum, it was so interesting.
senza di te non vedo più cieli blu. Senza di te il sole non brilla più.
This ancient but elaborate building was known as the Aqua Silius, or the pump room, where the Romans would come and drink their water before or after their baths. It's been turned into a modern day tea room. Al and I opted for the patio so that we could watch people and enjoy the esplendade. Every ancient city has their cathedral. This place is no different. The priest who wanted to build this cathedral had a dream of angels climbing a stairway. You'll see the ladders with the angels on them ascending up to heaven. That was his divine inspiration for building this cathedral.